I flew from Houston, Texas to Orlando, Florida, and I captured some incredible imagery with my 4K camera in infrared. Have a look.
We've just taken off from Houston and we're probably at about 20,000 feet. Have a look at this incredible flat earth, folks. This is not one of my favorite areas to photograph. Look at that. Look at those cloud shadows and maybe lakes as well. That's a reservoir right there. We're flying right on the edge of the Gulf of Mexico, folks. Now, as I bring the camera up, look at the distortion, folks. Incredible flat earth, folks. Behold the flat earth, folks. I've matched up this reality that we're seeing with the Google Earth, and it just doesn't compare. I actually set it to about 60% transparency and moved it off a little bit so you can see the features underneath and how closely it is matched. And notice where the horizon is. It's not even close, folks. Trust your eyes, folks. Just looking at that, we can tell it's flat and it just keeps going. But yet, there is a mystery here, folks. Our view is interrupted or cut off. That's the mystery, and we can sort of see a curve. It's like it's both flat, but it's also round. What is that phenomena? It's like the flat earth is just terminating out there. Let's have a look at this graphic. Notice the curvature here, the curved edge, and then I drew a straight line. And we can tell it's flat, but yet all of a sudden it's truncated. Is it a curved window effect? Is it visibility blocked by haze? Very mysterious, folks. I think it could be both. Let's continue. Just amazing, folks. Just look at these views out the window in infrared. I'm using a Sony AX53 camera that has the night shot mode with a 950 nanometer infrared filter. And that's what we get. Look at these clouds. Wow, they resemble turtles. You guys see the turtles? Flying turtles. Oh man, I'm just amazed by these views. Just soak this stuff up, folks. It's incredible. Just incredible. Look at that. Wow. Now we're gonna zoom in. Look at this zoom, folks. That land is right up underneath the clouds, folks. Look at that. If it wasn't for the clouds and the shadows, we couldn't quite tell where the ground is. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Just look at that, folks. Wow. Wow, this zoom is so incredible. Look at those clouds way in the distance.
haze is blocking our view, otherwise we would see even farther. And look at the cloud shadows on the ground, indicating the ground is right there. Simply incredible stuff, folks. The sunlight is coming at a shallow angle. It's late in the evening. Yeah, some of those dark areas could be bodies of water, not just cloud shadows. I also noticed that due to perspective, we can see ground in the distance above the clouds in the foreground. And it's all due to perspective, folks. Very interesting imagery here, folks. Let's continue, because there's a whole lot more.
This contrast, folks, is unbelievable. I can never get tired of looking at this beautiful contrast of the flat Earth. Unbelievable. Now we're gonna zoom in again. Look at all the parcels of land on the ground. What a amazing lake. Look at that. Look at the extent of this flat area. Wow. Wow, just look at that, folks. You notice haze is blocking our view in the distance, but that perspective of the ground just keeps going and going. It is flat. It's not rolling away out of sight behind the curvature. Just incredible, folks. The flat Earth is a reality, folks. It is an observed reality. Just incredible. Who would have thought that in 2018 infrared is going to reveal the flat Earth to us like never before? We're watching the world with new eyes, really. New eyes. Now, let's continue, because there's more. Wow, just look at the zoom. I guess I wasn't zoomed in all the way. Now we're gonna have a really nice journey through the clouds. Watch this scenery. It is simply incredible. The two lakes in the distance, and the river. River is Mississippi, and to the right, that's Lake Pontchartrain. I think that's how you pronounce it. Have a look at this scenery. This is the power of infrared, folks. Take a look, invisible spectrum. We hardly see anything out there on the horizon, just haze. But when I switch the camera to night shot mode, then it's susceptible to infrared. I'm switching it to infrared. Then I add a filter, an IR950 nanometer filter on the front. And now we can see clearly. I also desaturate the clip in my editing software. Look at that, folks. We're flying over the Gulf of Mexico. We're looking northeast towards the Florida coastline. That's St. Joseph Bay right there. Just look at this stuff, folks. Incredible. Just incredible. I'm gonna be zooming in shortly here on buildings nearby on the coast. Here we go. See those buildings on the left of the bay? Right there, the white dots. Wow. And over there too. Just incredible stuff, folks. This infrared is almost miraculous. We can certainly identify the St. Joseph Bay in the foreground, but I'm puzzled about that dark line. Is it the horizon? Is it mountains? Look at that, it seems to end towards the east. Now, I've done a 4-frame interpolation here, and it appears it may be the Appalachian Mountains, folks. This is just incredible. If we look at the map, they're over 500 plus miles away, and they seem to be in the correct direction, or at least end in the correct direction from our point of view. Simply incredible, folks. Wow, that was incredible, folks. This is just incredible. We have to do an analysis here, folks, to see exactly what we're seeing there. Let me explain my analysis, folks. So I built that yellow scale based on the distances of 71 miles and 79 miles across the bay, and then I took that distance and replicated it upwards. And what do you know? We come up to 0 degrees, right about where the eye level horizon seems to be. Then I also calculate the distances on a flat plane in white text. And then also in yellow, I calculate the distance on a globe surface. And on the left of the scale, I show where the globe horizon should be, and the globe horizon when refraction is taken into account, the 4/3 R approximation. Also notice there is a slight difference between 80 miles on the globe surface and the flat plane, 71. That translates into a small error. I calculated the distance on the globe surface of 80 miles based on the 5 degrees there. But if I were to calculate the angle based on 80 miles, you'd be about 5.4 degrees, I believe. But anyway, the world appears flat, so that's why I'm calculating things based on the flat Earth. However, what is really obvious here, folks, is that nothing really matches. The horizon is not where it's supposed to be. We don't really live on a globe. It's not in the right place. Those mountains, you know, they're not quite at the distance I thought they should be at. It's very puzzling, folks. Our world could be very strange and mysterious. There could be extremely flat spots on it as well, if it's really a spherical or flatoid or ellipsoid or whatever it may be. But out here in the US, so far on my flights, it appears that the world is really flat, folks. How is it in your part of the world? Anyway, thanks for watching, folks. Don't forget to subscribe. There's a whole lot more coming, folks. Stay tuned. Thanks again.